Hello friends, welcome to the virtual class. I hope that everyone of you are well there. In our today's class, we are going to start our new chapter, that is chapter 8, Air and Water. In our today's class, we will read about air and some of the uses of air. Okay, so let us start our today's session. Okay, air is all around us. Okay, air is everywhere, even the room where you are sitting right now. There is also air. We cannot see air. Can we see air? No. Just turn around and try to find air. Can you see it? No. We cannot see air and we cannot feel air when it is clean. Okay. When air is clean, we cannot feel it. But we can feel air when it moves. Okay. When air moves, we can feel it. Like when wind blows, we can feel air. Isn't it? And we can listen, we can hear air also. Okay. When air moves faster, when wind moves faster, we can listen the sound of air. Okay, I think you have noticed about it, isn't it? And air is important for we all living beings, for all living creature. Okay, like we human beings, including animals, birds, insect, plant. Okay, we all of us, we need air. Okay, like animals, birds, insect, we human being, we use air to breathe. Okay, we need air for breathing. Likewise, plants, trees, they use air to prepare their food. Okay, in order to make food, plants, trees, they need air. Okay, air contains some gases like oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide, and air also contains dust particles, chemicals and germs. Burning of firewood, plastics, papers. Likewise, firecracker, smoke coming out from vehicles, factories makes air polluted. Okay, and polluted air harms us. Okay, we may fall sick due to polluted air, and it is our duty, it is our responsibility to minimize, to reduce the amount of air pollution. Okay, so can you tell me how can we reduce air pollution? Okay, so by doing a lot of plantation, okay, it will help. Okay, by doing plantation, it will help to reduce the air pollution. Okay, and there are a few more uses of air also, so let us read about it. Okay, so here are some of the uses of air. Okay, so let us go point wise point. Okay, so first one, animals, insects, human being, etc. use air for breathing. Okay, we human being, like as I have said to you before, we human beings, animals, birds, insects, okay, use air to breathe. Second one, air is used to dry clothes. In order to dry clothes, we need air. Air helps to sail boat. Okay, in order to sail boat, we need air. Fourth one, hospital give oxygen to patient who are short of breath. Okay, oxygen, hospital also provide oxygen. Okay, for those patients who are short of breath. Fifth one, drivers need oxygen cylinder for breathing under water. Okay, under water, driver needs oxygen cylinder in order to breathe. Sixth one, air helps plants to prepare their food. As I have said before, in order to make food, plants need air. Okay, and the last one here. Okay, air is also used to produce musical sound in different instruments like harmonium, flute, etc. Okay, so this is all about the uses of air. Okay, and I hope that now you are able to say about some of the uses of air, isn't it? So moving to your homework, we have here. Okay, so here is your homework. Please note down your homework in your one number. Write any five uses of air. Okay, so you have to write down any five uses of air. Okay, so here are some of the uses of air. Okay, you can see here and you can write it, or you can make your own answer and you can write it. Okay, two number, name any three gases that air contains. Any three gases that air contain. Three number, what are the reasons for air pollution? Okay, there are various reasons for air pollution. You have to just write down any three reasons. Okay, fourth one, do we need air to fly kite? Okay, so to fly kite, okay, to fly kite, do we need air? Okay, so that one. Fifth one, can we feel air? Okay, can we feel air? And the last one, sixth one, we have here, can we see air? Okay, can we see air? Okay, so this is your homework. And if you have any kind of confusion, please do take help from your elder one. Okay,